Hello, this is Dave for That's Us Gaming, and welcome to Dave's Ramblings, where I basically talk your ear off about things I find interesting. Now, currently, there's a lot of fuss and a lot of coverage from people a lot better than I, currently casting a critical eye over loot boxes and predatory gaming mechanics. But one game that is very rarely mentioned, and I think it gets a free pass way too often, is Roblox. And today, I will dive in and just show you what I mean.
I've been down the Mississippi, down through New Orleans. Yes, I have. I've played in California. There ain't too much I haven't seen. No, there ain't. But I'm a rambling man. Don't fool around with a rambling man.
Roblox, for those of you out of the loop, is a game and toy line where the children can collect the toys, they get access to in-game items, and the game itself is a big mashup of a lot of different games. It's highly customizable and people make the games themselves. And if I'm honest, some of the games are actually really good. There's a game called The Schoolhouse where it's an online multiplayer version of Baldi's Basics, which was the hit indie game. And essentially, it's almost like Dead by Daylight. Four of you are the students, one of you is the teacher, and the students have to get the notebooks before the teacher can catch them. And it's a very, very good game. But there's also role-playing sims like Adopt Me and Bloxburg, which are very popular. There's even first-person shooters on there, the likes of Arsenal, where you choose a team, you basically, as soon as you kill someone, you get spawned a random weapon after killing someone. So sometimes you might be stuck with a bloody slingshot, other times you might have a bazooka, but as soon as you get that kill, it changes your gun. And to be honest with you, a lot of them are actually, like I said, very, very well done. And it's generally, the whole game is just wholesome fun. Now, I say generally because it also happens to be an absolute hive of paedophiles and trolls who think it's really funny to use mechanics in the game to play music with swearing and racial slurs, anything like that. Just typical troll stuff, putting NPCs in sexual positions. But the predatory nature, what we're focusing on now, comes in the form of user-created obstacle courses, or obbies, as they're generally known. These games are usually along the same line of escape this or escape that, and while generally fun, there are those that exist purely to get money off you. Now, in these obstacle courses, essentially, they are just that, you know, you've got to just not fall off something or make sure you jump over these at the right time, that sort of thing. But in a game, you can add items to your game that people pay a premium currency called Robux, for, and creators can exchange these Robux for real world currency from Roblox. And that's what I read when I was looking up. Now, this doesn't sound too bad for games that put in a fair effort and create genuinely fun games. But one of the big problems I currently have with Roblox is just the complete amount of no effort shit obbies that are just littered with premium items in the most ludicrous places. I'm talking about being placed right as you make a jump. So on the Xbox, you press A to jump just as a purchase screen pops up. It's ridiculously predatory, especially if your child is playing on a Fire tablet or just a tablet in general and just taps random buttons when something comes up. This lesson nearly cost me an arm and a leg, especially because on the Fire tablet, Amazon have one-touch payment, which, of course, I'd never thought of it as anything other than just simplicity, I suppose, and convenience. I never thought it would be used like that. Luckily, I spotted this in time and just managed to snatch the tablet before he had pressed for something stupid. As I say, it was just like a premium item on this hobby. And honest to God, I would have dread to think how much could have been spent on bloody flying carpets and fucking springs and shit. Now, this game is aimed primarily at children, especially with the tie-in toys too, and people like the Toy Heroes on YouTube constantly making videos about Roblox for kids, and also the fact that you can have an under 13 and an over 13 account. But there needs to be things in place to stop accidental spending. I had to give my four-year-old my old Xbox Live account I'd set up for Final Fantasy XI, and I had to completely remove all payment options just so we could play the games, you know, without accidentally buying anything. That's absolutely ridiculous. Just a simple turn off payment options would be fucking great, rather than all this roundabout rubbish. I mean, I don't want to remove my payment options from Amazon or Xbox. It's an absolute ball ache to re-add a card only to remove it for the next time he wants to play. And as I say, it's annoying because Roblox is a great game for him. The privacy wise, you know, there's nobody can talk to him. You know, he just goes about doing his own thing. But as I say, nobody can talk to him. He can't talk to them. He's pretty much in his own little bubble. But they would, as I say, they don't have anything to stop that accidental stuff. So, like I said, I really think that they need to get on these predatory games, because at the moment, everyone is focusing on EA, Activision, etc., who are, while yes, being an absolute pain in the ass, they're still not trying to steal your money. You have to know that you are buying these things, whereas Roblox is walking around essentially trying to steal money. Well, it's not even them. It's the users of the game who are trying to get people to buy premium items. And as I say, some of the, honest to God, right, a hand on heart, some of these games on Roblox that people have put genuine effort into are actually better than some of the £50 games you can buy now. Honest to God. And they're great for kids, but as I say, there needs to be some sort of, as I say, accidental payment thing, or even just more parental controls to turn off spending. But until then, I honestly think that they need to clamp down on all these people who just, honestly, the radius for these items, they'll just put it just to the side, just so you have to either walk through it to get to the next obstacle, or you might land on it, or if you spawn after falling off an obstacle, because that's what it mainly is, it's the obstacles, you will end up with a bloody great big purchase screen on there. Yeah, so that's pretty much it. Thank you very much for listening. Sorry I've been away for a while. It's been quite hard to get some quiet time to sort out my recording and stuff, but hopefully I'll be back to fortnightly videos again. And please like, share, and subscribe, and I will see you all soon. Bye.